Talk to us about what governments can do to further accelerate the development of this technology, not only for their own ends as military services, but also or for military applications, but also for the commercial world.
So governments in different countries are already doing quite a lot, and governments can continue to help support this technology. Number one, facilities. You need to be able to test this equipment for real and then move on. Investment in facilities, infrastructure is key. Secondly, investment in people. People and talent, be that in universities, in SMEs, and the bigger players, and mechanism to collaborate. Thirdly, I think an endorsement at the highest levels. So it really has to be endorsed at ministerial level to say this is important, it is a strategy, it's an enduring strategy that we will persist and ride the wave on.
And George Zambellis, when he was first Sea Lord, full disclosure, Admiral Zambellis and I know each other very well, but we were talking about how important, he was a key figure in those tri-service exercises a few years ago. How important was that, bringing together air systems, surface systems, subsurface systems together in this sort of space to help drive autonomy?
So first Sea Lord then, Sir George Zambellis, was a key driving force for the Royal Navy. Without his endorsement, I'm not sure that we would have got to where we got to in the UK, whereby we had a world first. We were controlling 10 unmanned assets, a squad, using a minimum number of operators. They were doing a mine hunting task, so we had mine hunters under the water, above water vessels, and the Blue Bear UAV actually providing a comms relay. So George Zambellis very bravely stood up a fleet robotics officer. His name was Commander Steve Prest, later taken over by Commander Peter Pipkin. These guys really drove what happened, got the industry engagement. They facilitated an awful lot of the work. Then Admiral Paul Bennett, who led the team on autonomy, again, an amazing amount of ownership from Sir George Zambellis down his team to then the industry players, as well as government labs. The UK government labs, DSTL, did an awful lot. They put in the legwork and the hard work for many years to get industry together to then work cooperatively. So Sir George Zambellis led the charge.
Well, we're going to be talking to him hopefully tomorrow, so I'll pass along your very best on it.